So what's the difference between the piranha dog that I mentioned, which is a cross of American bully used for protection work, combined with Pachelder Terrier blood to make it smaller and also add working capabilities, which is a performance bred dog? What's the difference with that as compared to, for example, pocket pits? Well, pocket pits, also pocket bullies, can be created and are often created just as ornamental type of dogs. Often they are very extreme. They also call them extreme or exotics or all the other stuff because there is a lot of other blood in them. Often the blood for the to get the dogs down in size, and also even more extremely big and bully, is of course more bulldog blood. And this bulldog blood is a show type of bulldog, the English bulldog. And also the to get them even smaller, French bulldogs are added, or other small terriers can be added, like Pachelder. But then you get a dog that's less extreme than a normal pit bull would be, or Jack Russells, which are also low on their feet, and then cross in a lot of bull blood again to get the dogs very, very small. Also, by inbreeding them, you can get quick results, and inbreeding leads to inbreeding depression, which also results in smaller type of dogs. So that's the difference between the piranha dog and the pocket pit, or the pocket bully, or extreme pocket bully, micro bully, or whatever they are calling them. So one is aimed at some kind of performance, to get a dog that's easy with children and can be a deterrent, and also protect the children if needed, whereas still remaining on the smaller side of the spectrum. The other one is to look as extreme as possible and be like in a status symbol kind of thing. They also say that there is a thing like pitter-pats, which are crosses between normally pits, so like pit bulls and pachelders, either for show purposes, but mostly for work. For example, if you need a dog that has all the hunting capabilities of a pachelder, but needed to be a little bit bigger, sometimes pachelder blood is entered. If you need a dog that is a little bit more tenacious or has a stronger bite, sometimes pit bull blood is added. Or if there is a inbreeding depression because you breed your line so tight that you need an out, and there is no other good pachelder families available, sometimes they use pit blood. It could also be sometimes that in the development of the pachelder, some, for example, locally, because this is a pachelder developed in England, some blood was added. Or for example, Staffordshire Bull Terrier that was available there, and then wash it down with a lot of terrier again. So there might be also some bull in the pachelder, and also the pachelders were developed from dogs, like dogs that were also at the time being developed in other type of terriers, or even the Staffordshire Bull Terriers, we know them now. So there is always a little bit of overlap, and if you're looking for dogs that could bring the size down for a pit, or increase the size or strength for a pachelder, those crosses are often named pitter-pats. So that's there you have it. That's my lowdown on this three names that are used for crosses that could include pachelder, the micro bullies, and all the other stuff. I don't think there's any pachelder then. For all the dogs that need to be ornamental or as extreme as possible, you don't need pachelder blood, because a pachelder is a more harmonized type of dog, so less, less express and less extreme, whereas for example bulldog is very extreme. But even then, they managed to get the micro bullies to look even worse and then for even worse confirmation than, for example, some English bulldogs have, which is such a pity. Also, those noses are almost flat, and some exotic micro booties that I saw. This is my Petterdale, this 11 month old male. He's named BSL Estacado. He's a cross between two Petterdale lines, boot on the top and the cloat on the bottom. He's holding his ball, one of his greatest assets that he likes. And I hope you have a very nice day.